हेलो, माय सेल्फ एहकाम अंसारी। वेलकम टू दिस चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, दैट इज एडवांस वेब डिजाइनिंग। दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ योर एग्जाम बट ऑल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ योर करियर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, इफ यू आर सीकिंग योर करियर इन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी और आईटी, बिकॉज टुडे इज अ वर्ल्ड ऑफ आईटी एंड वी आर लर्निंग वेब डिजाइनिंग। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न हाउ टू डिजाइन एंड डेवलप डिफरेंट वेब पेजेस, वेबसाइट्स एंड डिफरेंट वेब एप्लीकेशन बाय यूजिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज सच एज HTML, JavaScript एंड CSS। आई थिंक एट दिस पॉइंट वन क्वेश्चन मे बी पॉप अप इन योर माइंड दैट सर, इज दिस न्यू थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न और द ओल्ड वन विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न इन स्टैंडर्ड 11? योर क्वेश्चन इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट। दिस थिंग वी हैव लर्न इन स्टैंडर्ड 11, बट इन स्टैंडर्ड 12 वी विल लर्न सम एडवांस वर्जन और सम एडवांस नॉलेज ऑफ वेब डिजाइनिंग और हाउ टू क्रिएट वेब एप्लीकेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ डिफरेंट एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजीज। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न समथिंग न्यू, समथिंग अपग्रेडेड, वेयर दिस चैप्टर इज इटसेल्फ वेरी सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी, दैट द चैप्टर नेम इज एडवांस वेब डिजाइनिंग। मीन्स वी हैव टू लर्न एडवांस वर्जन ऑफ वेब डिजाइनिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज। सो गेट रेडी टू अपग्रेड योर एटीट्यूड एंड एप्टीट्यूड towards new web technologies. In this chapter, we will learn some advanced feature, advanced application of HTML5. If I say HTML5, you must remember HTML5 we have started in standard 11. So what is HTML5? You will say HTML5 or HTML is a tool or language which helps or which is used to design or develop attractive web pages. And HTML5 is a latest version of HTML series starting from HTML 1.5. And now we are using HTML5. So this is the advanced version with the new technologies, new feature and new application. So student, we will start with first topic of this chapter, that is, I mean, information technologies. First chapter, that is, we have already discussed advanced web designing. So in this chapter, the first topic we will take for today's lecture is forms or input. So what is form actually? In general, form is a medium or source to collect different type of information. For example, if you want to take admission in any college or university, or you are going to fill any form for your ticket, or you are going to book any ticket, in that case, you have to fill some form. That is some registration form or some admission form. So in that form, we have to pass our information or like personal information. Like we have to pass our name, our contact number, our address, our date of birth, our date of journey. This information we have to pass, means we have to provide different types of data. So input form or form is a medium or channel or source which is used to accept information from user. But in that case, in our daily life, or if you are going to take admission in your university or college, in that case we fill form in the form of different hard copy or paper. But in IT or in web designing, we have to create this form by using different technology like CSS or HTML or JavaScript. So we will create a form by using CSS, JavaScript or HTML5. So let's have a look how to create this form or how to design this form. So as we know, if you want to use HTML5 or HTML or CSS, we have a software, we have an editor called Notepad. So you can use any editor, but we will start with the help of Notepad only. Why? Because Notepad is a simplest software which is used to design our web pages. And it helps to learner to learn everything from the basic. If you use any upgraded or any text editor like Notepad++ or any editor, you will get coding easily. But if you use Notepad, so it will provide blank page. So you will learn from scratch. That's why we will use Notepad only. So let's start Notepad. As you know, Notepad is a built-in software given by the Windows. So just directly go to your application where all the applications are installed. So just type Notepad. So you will get Notepad. Click on Notepad. So it will start, and we will start our first web application, that is use of HTML and creation of first form by using HTML5. So I will start by this line, and please pay attention, I am writing not doc type. HTML. This line is very important. Student, please pay attention. The line which I am going to highlight, that is not doc type HTML. What is mean by that line? Before HTML5, we have n number of version like HTML4, HTML3, HTML2, HTML1.0, and many more we have in between. But this line of code shows or tells the browser that which version of HTML you are using. Before HTML5, you are not going to write any line on start, but in HTML5 we have to write doc type HTML. This line tells that you are using HTML5. As we know, HTML or any web language are working as per the standard of W3C, that is World Wide Web Consortium, and all the web developer or web designer have to follow the standard given by that consortium. So if you are going to use HTML5, in that case you have to write this line, that is doc type is HTML. After that you have to start HTML page, because you already know, you have already learned in standard 11 that the HTML page is starting with the HTML starting and HTML closing. And the next tag will be our head tag, the top, and second tag will be closing head tag, and the next tag will be body tag, and after tag we have to write closing body tag. Those who are new or they don't understand what I am going to write, the first tag of the HTML page will be HTML and the last tag will be HTML. So how I come to know which one is first tag, which one is last tag? We have a par tag. We have two types of tag. One is par tag and one is unpar tag. Par tag means we have two same tag, like see, this one is a HTML and this one is a closing HTML. So what is the difference between this HTML and this HTML? So we have only one difference, that is a difference of that forward slash. Okay, so this forward slash shows that this tag is a closing tag. In the same way, just check in this tag, that is this one is a head tag and this is a closing tag. So closing head tag have a forward slash. So forward slash indicate that this tag is a closing tag. If you don't know or if you don't have any idea about HTML tag, so let's have a view. See this slide. I have created this slide. Forms in HTML5, form tag and input tag. We have to create a form, and as we know, if you are going to create a form tag, we have to use form tag and input tag. Like in standard 11, we have used creation of table. So if you are going to create a table, so first thing you have to write is a table tag. Under table tag, we have some sub tag, that is tr and td tag. In the same way, if you are going to create a form in HTML5 or in HTML, first you have to write form tag like this, and we have to use input tag inside that tag. Or you can say input tag is a sub tag of form tag. So those who are new to HTML tags, I am just giving this explanation. See example one, form, then we have a name, then we have an equal to sign, then we have in double quoted we have written something. So HTML or line of code is consist of three thing. HTML line of code is consist of three thing. One is HTML tag. See, form is HTML tag where name is HTML attribute. and equal to sign in double and comma I have written acom. What is acom? Here acom is indicated as a value of that attribute. So HTML tag consists of HTML tag, HTML attribute and value of that attribute. So form is a HTML tag, name is a HTML attribute or attribute of that tag, and acom is a value of that attribute. So we have three things: one is HTML tag, and one is HTML attribute, and one is HTML value. So values are written inside the double and comma. In the same way, if you are going to use input tag, again here input is a HTML tag, type is a attribute, and text is a value. These attribute and values are given by the HTML. Okay, as we know, HTML is a tool to create or to design attractive web pages, or it's a language, that is HTML hypertext markup language, is a language which is used to design attractive web pages. So every language follows certain rules and regulation. Like if I am using Hindi or English or Marathi, so in that case I am using certain rules and regulation. That rules and regulation are called as a grammar. So if I want to learn or I want to use that language, we have to learn this grammar or do this rules. So if you are going to use HTML5 or HTML, you have to follow rules and regulation given by the HTML5 language. These rules and regulation or grammar is called as a syntax in IT or in information or in computer languages. So we have to follow these syntax. Means if you are going to take any HTML tag, the first thing you have to use is a HTML tag inside the less than or closing the bracket. Then we have to use a tag name, that is a form or any tag. We have hundreds of HTML tags inside the HTML. Then we have to use their specified attribute. After that we have to assign some value of that attribute. Here acom is an attribute of form name. Acom is a value of form name attribute. Then method, which method we are following. We have different meaning of this attribute. We will discuss later. But in this lecture, I just want to refresh your standard 11 that HTML tags have HTML tag, HTML attribute and HTML values. Okay. Now back to our notepad, that we are going to create one form by using HTML5. So I have created this form. Now when you create any HTML page, first thing you have to use these six lines. These are some compulsory line of code which you have to write for any page. So now I am going to save this file so you can get the output, what we are going to output after saving this file. So click on save. So it will ask where you want to save. So currently I am saving on desktop. See the desktop, save as desktop, and ask the file name, because first time I am going to create this file. So it will ask for the file name. So I will assign some file name, for example, my first page. You can assign any name, my first page. So my first page is a name of my file. Then we have to write .html. .html is an extension of that file. Extension means the type of file which I am going to create. Means we have, if you don't write .html, it will take as a by default text document, that is .txt. So I am going to create a web page by using HTML. So I have to write .html. So it will create or it will generate HTML file. So click on save button. Minimize this. Then come to desktop. See this one, my first page, this file I have created. This file looks like a browser file. So double click. So double click or right click, open with in browser. So this is called as a, we are going to run our program. First we have to write inside the notepad, then we have to run, or we can simply double click. Now you will see this page, my first page is a name of page, and currently my whole web page is a blank. Why? Because till now I have not written any page. Okay, So I am going to write the coding. So where to write code? Inside BodyTech. Inside BodyTech, if you write anything, it will display. When you click on file, when you make any changes, please click on save. So click on save. Again, I am going to minimize. So again, I am going to run this program. Just refresh this page. You can refresh from here or you can directly click F5. So see, the thing which I have written inside the BodyTech, it displayed inside the browser. Okay. Now again, minimize this page and flip back to our notepad. Okay. So remove this thing because we have to use HTML5. I'm going to take one more HTML tag, that is H1. As you also know, H1 is a tag which is used to assign heading to your content. For example, I'm going to write register, that is forms in HTML. So I am going to write form in HTML5. Okay, this is a heading. Just you have made some changes, just click on file, click on save, again back to your browser. Okay, see, again refresh the page, so you will get form in HTML and see the changes. Before, when I write something inside the body without tag, it was a little, and I want to just increase the size so you can clearly view the page. Okay, so currently it shows in a little bold because I am using H1, and H1 you know used for heading. Again, flip back to our HTML5 page. Now I have to use form tag. Okay, so I will write form. I can take n number of attribute which is given by the HTML for the form tag, but right now it's not my intention to learn attribute of form tag, but to learn attribute of input tag or sub tag of form. So closing form tag. Okay, then inside that I will take, for example, I'm going to create a form. Like in form we have to pass certain information like our name. So enter your name, you will write enter your name. Okay, after that I am going to use input tag. So I will take input. Then we have an attribute called type. Type equal to, you have to write text. Okay, so this is the hard code, and I'm using input. In input tag we have three things. One is input. What is input? We have already learned input is a name of tag. And what is type? Type is a attribute. And what is a text? Text is a value. Okay, so before going to further, I just want to show the output so you can learn from each line of code line by line. Okay, I'm just moving to your HTML5 browser. I'm going to click F5. See, enter your name, it is hard coded which I have typed, but this box is coming by using input type equal to text. Means it will create a box in which we can insert something called text. If I say text means number as well as character as well as symbol. See I can write character, I can write number, and I can write symbol. So if you use input type equal to text, you can insert text like number, like symbols and character. Okay, flip back to your notepad. Now you have taken input type equal to text and you are going to insert some name. Sometime we have to pass information like contact number. So enter contact number. I have just written, again I have to use input type. Input type equal to text. For example, if you write input type equal to text, see the changes. Click on save. If you are going to add or delete a single line of code or single character, please click on save button. Just click F5 for refresh. Now you will get one more, that is input type equal to text. So inside name, if I am going to write character, number, or some symbol, you can write. But as we know, if I write enter the contact number inside that, if I type something like character, so logically it's not logical. Are you getting my point? Means contact number must be in number. So if any user comes and type ABC inside the contact number, so it is not logical. So in that case, HTML5 provide one thing that is called input type equal to number. Okay, input type equal to number. So you can only enter number in this box. Click on save, flip back to your browser, click F5, that is you are going to refresh the page. Now inside that text box you can insert number only. See, I think you can't see my keyboard, so let me show some on keyboard so you may understand in a very clear manner. See, this is my on key keyboard. I'm just going to delete here. When I click on that, I'm using this keyboard. I'm typing T U U I. Okay, then some number. Okay, now in this I have taken input type equal to number. When I click on that text box again, I am going to type. See, all you, I'm sure you are getting my point. When I click A S D, these are some characters and I have taken input type equal to number, so I'm unable to type. But when I click on number 1, 2, 3, you can easily see it only accept number. It is unable to accept any characters. Yes, are you getting? Thank you. I'm going to close this keyboard because I'm using hard keyboard. So I just want to show how input type equal to number take number only. Now one thing, because I am working in IT or I am going to design a form, so I want this line of code, that is enter contact number, in next line, because both the text box is coming on the same line. So I will just go back to my file and I will add, because enter your name, after that we have a box, I want a new line from there. So I will just add one HTML tag, that is a br. I think you have already learned what is the use of br. So I just want to refresh your mind. Br is used to break the line. So if you use br, it will break the line from that text box. So click on save. Okay, you can use Control S also. I'm just going to flick back to my browser, click F5. Okay, so you will get text box on the next line, the first text box and the second text box. Okay, if you want more line, again use one more br. So br basically break the line or add blank line. So click on save. I'm just using this because you can properly see what I am going to do. Every time I am not using Control S because you cannot see my hard keyboard. So Control S is also working, or you can click on save. Again, flip back to your HTML browser, click F5. So see, you can get one more extra line, that is by using br, means it will break new line. So we have seen input type called text. In that we can insert some text, number or character, but we have taken input type equal to number. Inside that you can take only numbers. I am going to use one more feature of HTML5. We are going to take one more type, that is sometime you have to enter your DOB, means you have to enter your date of birth. So before HTML5 you have to type manually, but HTML5 provide a tool. HTML5 provides a tool, that is form, and inside that form it added one type of attribute inside the input tag. Input type equals to date. So please, while it's a very interesting input type, is a date is a newly added feature of HTML5 which were not present in HTML4. This is used to accept date of birth or any types of date from the user, but it will create a calendar. It will very attractive. Actually, it's a very beautiful feature of the HTML5. It will create a calendar. By using that calendar, you can select any date. So again, I'm going to add one BR. I think you could understand what is the use of BR. So one more BR, that is break line. It will assign two new blank line. So input type equal to date. I'm going to click this file, save this file. Okay. Flip back to your browser so you can clearly show the output. Click F5. Now see, you will get one more text box, or it's not a text box, it's an input type equal to date. So if you take input type equal to date, it will create this type of field where you can write your date from here. You can add any date. Okay. You can use this scroll bar to increase this one for decrease. Okay. If you don't want to type or if you don't want to write, you can directly click on that box. It will create a calendar. By using that calendar, you can take any date. Okay. Any month, any year. It's a very beautiful feature of HTML5. So you can assign any date. Okay. I think this feature you will like. Yes. Yes or no. Please comment if you like this feature. Comment below in this video. Now we have more thing to learn, but I just don't want to make this video very long. So I will just add one more thing, that is input type equals to, I will take button, or not button, input type equal to submit, and so I have written input type equal to submit. Click on save. Just please save this file back to your browser and you will see nothing. Why? I have added one thing, that is input type equal to submit, but on my browser, let me refresh. So you will say, sir, you will not refresh the page. Let me refresh. F5 again, input type equal to submit. So if you write input type equal to submit, it will get submit by default. Okay. If you want to change that submit, which is written inside the button, so you have to use one attribute, that is value. You have to write value. Value equals to, you can assign okay, or you can assign say, or you can assign anything. If you write value equal, value is an attribute, like your input is an attribute. What is submit? Submit is a value. Okay. And value is an attribute and save is a value of value attribute. So click on save button again back to your browser. Currently it's a working as a submit, but when you refresh the page, you will get save, because whatever write inside the value attribute, it will display on your button. So if you want to change to okay, just click okay. Okay. Save it. Again, back to your browser, refresh the page. Okay, so you will get okay. So this file is used to save the content of your web page. I'm going to add one more thing, that is I'm going to a reset button. This thing you already know, that's why I'm not going to discuss more about this input type equal to submit. I am just control C, control B, because I want to save your time. Input type equal to submit, instead of submit, I am going to take reset. As you know, what is the use of reset? Reset is a button like submit, but it is used to clear the content of your page. Whatever you have written inside the form, it will clear. So value, again, you know what is the value, it will display on your button. If you write value edit, so it will show edit. Click on file, click on save. Again, flip back to your browser. Again, refresh the page. So it will add one more line, one more button, that is edit. So when you write something in input, for example, I have written Ahkam Ansari in my name. I have written my contact number 93210949914. Then I am going to add my date of birth. For example, any date of birth I have taken instead of so, for example, 9p, it's not a correct, okay, click OK. So it will submit the form, but I just want to show you what is the use of reset button. You choose any date, for example, this one you have taken. Now when you click on this button, as we know, edit is a button. I just want to increase the, I just want to zoom this. Okay, so when you click on edit, edit is an input type equal to reset button. When you click on edit, it will erase the data. Okay, so input type equal to submit. When you click on submit button, okay, so it will save the file where you want to save. When you click on that, it will move to file. But currently we are not given some attribute of form tag where that data can be saved or can be sent. So inside that we can add some attribute like name equal to, for example, A, then action equals to kms.php, then method equals to, we can take post. Okay, name, what is the name? Again, name is an attribute of form tag. Okay, what is A? A is a value, you can assign any name. What is the action? This one is very important. Actually, I want to continue in next lecture, but let's see. Action is an attribute of form tag which is used to send your file. The whole data of your form will be transferred to kms.php. okay, kms.php is a server page where I am going to send this file. And what is the method attribute? The use of method attribute is means which method you are going to follow to send this. We have two types of method. We have two values. One is post and one is get. If you are using get method, so your data will be shown on your URL on your browser and it will send only 255 character. But if you are using post, the data will be sent directly to kms.php without showing on the URL. So post method is a very secure method to sending information by using a form. We will discuss these attribute of form tag, but I just want to refresh this video. First, we have started with the HTML5. Then we have seen some form tag. Then inside the form tag, we have taken input tag. In input tag, we have taken type attribute and we have different types of input. One is text, one is a number, one is an input type equal to submit. We have seen input type equal to reset. We have many, many things to learn in this chapter. So please keep learning, keep watching this video. And if you have any query related to this video, please comment below. Myself, Ahkam Ansari, I would like to thank for watching my channel, my video. Please comment if you like. Thank you. Thank you very much.